recent extraterrestrial incursion, this Council of Nations has convened to approve the activation of the XCOM project. You have been chosen to lead this initiative, to oversee our first and last line of defense. Your efforts will have considerable influence on this planet's future. We urge you to keep that in mind as you proceed. Good luck, Commander.
That was the last transmission, sir.
Patch me through to Voodoo 3-1.
You are being deployed to Germany. At 1900 hours Zulu, several unidentified objects fell to Earth. After ruling out the possibility of a downed satellite, we now believe these objects to be extraterrestrial in nature. Shortly after impact, German officials received reports of mass hysteria and freak weather around one of the impact zones. Then things went dark. At 2100 hours, a chopper carrying a German military recon team went down in the area after they reported being fired upon. As you know, Germany is a member of the Council, and they have requested our assistance. Our mission is to assess the situation on the ground, ascertain the current status of the German recon team, and investigate the extraterrestrial objects. Central out.
Central, this is Big Sky. Looks like we found the crash site.
Roger, Voodoo 3-1. Any sign of activity?
Negative. Nothing's moving down there.
Okay. Set her down nearby.
Central, you getting all this?
Copy that, Delta Squad. First things first, let's get you out of the open and into cover. Whatever did this could still be out there.
Central, I have movement. 30 meters north of my position. Police vehicle.
Roger. Proceed to the next vehicle for a better vantage point. Delta 4, go check it out. It's a long way from your position, and there's no available cover between here and there, so you better double time it.
Holy hell.
What do you see, Delta 4? Report.
Looks like one of the recon teams, sir. It looks like something.
Is that your man, Delta 4?
Negative, sir. That's someone else.
Dr. Vollen, what's he saying?
He is saying, help me. That radio transmission is coming from somewhere north of the squad's current position. Based on its strength, probably from inside a structure.
Central, I think I just found another one of the recon team. Or what's left of him. But this doesn't make sense. Looks like he's been dead for a week.
Even more perplexing is the cause of death. It appears that he was eviscerated when something burst out of him from the inside.
Sir, I have visual on the object. Permission to approach.
It's the only cover between you and that building. Permission granted.
Talk to me, soldier. What is it?
I got no idea what this thing is, but I can confirm that it's no satellite.
Roger. All right, Delta Squad. You're almost to the building. Keep moving.
Central, we have eyes on the target. He's armed.
Copy, Delta 3. Okay, everyone. Get into position nearby, but do not approach. Doctor, see if you can communicate with him. Tell him to drop his weapon.
I will try. Hello. Können Sie mich hören? Wir sind hier, um Ihnen zu helfen. Bitte lassen Sie Ihre Waffen fallen. He appears to be in shock.
Keep your eyes open, people. I don't like the looks of this. Delta 3, move in and disarm him. Carefully.
One is down.
Central, we're taking fire from multiple x-rays.
This guy's got me pinned down, taking heavy fire.
Damn it. Delta 2, you're flank 2. Find some better cover. All right, Delta 2. Weapons free. Get ready to fire. Nice shot. Delta 4, you're freed up to move. Get out of there and get into cover. Now toss your grenade at the enemy in front of you. Now get ready for their counterattack. Look out, Delta 4. There's another one coming in behind you. Damn it. It's just you now, Delta 2. Let's tip the odds in our favor. Look around for a position where you can flank the enemy. That's it. You have a clear shot from that position. Fire.
Central, I think that's it. It's over.
Roger that, Delta. Secure the bodies and head back to the Sky Ranger for immediate extraction. They nearly took out a squad of our best soldiers. If you'll excuse me, doctors, the commander is waiting in mission control.
Their technology is far beyond ours.
Then I'd say our work is cut out for us, Doctor.
Welcome to XCOM HQ, Commander. I'm Central Officer Bradford. My role in this project is twofold, providing tactical support for our field operations and keeping you briefed on the current situation. My efforts should allow you to focus on the bigger issues at hand. Speaking of which, we have a soldier waiting for a promotion in the barracks. I'll let you get to it.
Only one recruit from Delta Squad made it back alive from our last mission, Commander. And I'd say a promotion is in order. As you know, Commander, every soldier is different. This particular soldier has shown an aptitude for heavy weapons. As he gains additional combat experience, we should continue his training along these lines. This soldier will now carry a rocket launcher in addition to his standard weapon. The aliens won't know what hit him. Oh, Dr. Vollen asked to see you in the research labs, Commander. It sounded important.
Hello, Commander. My name is Dr. Vollen. I oversee the research labs. This is where all of XCOM's research and development takes place. We have already begun analyzing the artifacts recovered from our first encounter with the aliens. Based on our preliminary findings, we believe we can use them to develop some new equipment for our soldiers. With your approval, we will begin research immediately. Thank you, Commander. This research will take some time. We will notify you once it is complete.
Commander to mission control.
It sounds like you are needed elsewhere. Farewell, Commander. If you recover any additional artifacts during your field operations, I would be quite eager to study them.
The enemy is testing our capabilities, Commander. We've gotten reports of simultaneous attacks in two different countries. We can only respond to one. The country we help will donate more resources to our cause. But the panic level of the country we choose not to help will rise. It's not an easy decision, Commander, but it's one you'll have to make.
Understood. The troops are waiting for you in the hangar.
Commander, before deploying our squad, you can choose which soldiers to send out there. I've taken the liberty of calling up our veteran. His combat experience makes him invaluable on the battlefield.
The enemy and get into cover. Hold your fire until I give the word.
No longer a threat. Enemy spotted.
Our veteran's rocket launcher should make easy work of the structure the aliens are using for cover. And if we're lucky, it'll take out the aliens along with it. That is, if it hits. Commander will be assuming command now as you sweep the rest of the area. As always, I'll be offering tactical advice as needed. And remember, your armor can only withstand a couple of shots from their weapons, so keep your eyes open and your heads down. Good luck.
He's down.
Good work out there, Strike One.
If I may, Commander, the labs are on high alert. Teams are standing by for your orders. We can begin researching the newly recovered artifacts immediately.
Commander, we have an incoming transmission from the Council.
Hello, Commander. We wish to congratulate you on your most recent victory. We realize you were faced with a difficult decision in responding to the various requests for assistance. Regardless, you performed admirably. As agreed upon, the reward for your actions has been granted. Farewell, Commander. We hope that you are met with continued success.
The Council knows you made the right decision, Commander. With the resources we have available, there's only so much we can do. However, our chief engineer did come up with something to help you keep an eye on things.
The Situation Room provides constant monitoring of every member nation in the Council. If we allow panic levels to get out of control in any given nation, they're going to withdraw from the Council. And they'll take their funding and additional support with them. The Council's overall confidence in the XCOM project is shown on the primary meter above the main screen, which engineering has nicknamed the Doom Tracker.
Hello, Commander. The current research task is progressing as expected. However, it will still be some time before the schematics are ready for engineering. I'm sure you have other pressing matters to attend to in the meantime.
Commander, Dr. Vollen reports that research is progressing in the labs, but it will still be some time before the project is complete. While we're waiting, our local satellite network has just come online, and we can now begin scanning for new activity. The process could take several days.
Commander, with this research complete, my staff and I currently have nothing to study. I would like to ask your permission to autopsy the alien cadavers retrieved from your last two field operations. I'm sure you would agree that if we're going to defeat the aliens, we must understand their physiology. Thank you, Commander. I will let you know when this research has been completed. It appears Dr. Shen's staff have finally figured out how to turn their machines on.
Ah, Commander. I was wondering when you'd be stopping by. Welcome to engineering. Anything they can dream up in the research labs, we can build it here. Speaking of which, Dr. Vollen has just sent us some new schematics. With your approval, we will begin fabrication. Fabrication of the scope device is complete. It has been delivered to the armory.
We've made a number of interesting discoveries based on the autopsy results of the alien specimen you brought back. The research team is now referring to this particular variation as a sectoid, based on the unusual structure of its internal organs, which we believe to be the product of genetic manipulation. As we've seen in the field, this species also seems to harbor some sort of telepathic ability.
Commander, the Council has requested a word.
Commander, our sources have identified a number of reports regarding alien involvement in the transportation and dispersal of an unknown substance near civilian population centers. It is imperative that you investigate this activity and determine the purpose of the alien material. We will transmit further details momentarily.
Sounds like we better get to it.
object is different from the others. It does not appear to be the same type of pod we've seen used by the aliens during their abduction operations. We may gain new insights if we recover it.
Be advised, Commander. Intel confirms enemy activity in this area.
Solid copy.
This appears to be a containment device of some kind. We can only assume it has an internal self-destruct mechanism like the other alien equipment. Although it must have already been disabled somehow.
There may be additional canisters like this one in the area. The more we can recover, the more we'll learn about what's inside them.
Any others you find may still have operational self-destruct modules. Be careful. The energy signature coming from that device implies the self-destruct mechanism is still intact and priming for detonation. You need to move quickly to recover it before it's too late.
Excellent work, Commander. That should provide us with an ample supply of this substance for analysis.
So, what is it, Doctor?
It's remarkable. The crystalline structure housed within the canister is actually a suspension containing billions of cybernetic nanomachines, each made up of both organic and mechanical components.
My team's analysis indicates these microscopic robots are capable of assembling mechanical structures with unprecedented efficiency. With further study and some specialized facilities, we may be able to engineer a sort of cybersuit that interfaces with the human body.
My team is more interested in the possibility of physically altering the tissue itself, incorporating aspects of the alien's own genetic adaptations by using the nanites to fuse the foreign material.
The Commander will have to decide where the greatest advantage lies. Is there anything you agree on?
Given the apparent purpose of the nanites, they allow combining organic materials with one another, or with machines. We have at least agreed to call them
meld.
Should risk the lives of our troops so we can take one of these things alive.
Yes. Without a live specimen, I'm afraid we've reached the pinnacle of what my team is able to accomplish.
And how do you suggest we do this, Doctor?
The autopsy I've just completed confirms that the alien's physiology is quite similar to our own. A highly concentrated electrical current delivered at close range should cause neuromuscular...
Close range? And what happens if it doesn't work? Do you really think this is worth the risk?
I do. We do not know our enemy. How can we hope to stop something that we do not understand? If we can capture one of these creatures alive, we may be able to communicate with it.
And interrogate it. Find out what they want. Where they're operating from.
Yes. That possibility outweighs all risks, in my opinion. I can construct a safe enough facility to house our captive, but I do not know how we could possibly communicate with it.
Not to worry. I will see to that.
All right. I'll speak to the Commander. Commander, based on Dr. Vallen's report,
I recommend we begin researching the new weapon she's calling the Arc Thrower in the labs. Once completed, we can send the plans down to engineering for fabrication, and then equip one of our troops with it in the barracks. Dr. Shen and the engineering team are also waiting on approval for construction of the containment facility that we'll need in order to house the alien captive.
Commander, no doubt you are aware of Dr. Valen's request to capture one of the aliens. A sound plan, but she fails to realize that we lack a facility to safely contain a live specimen. With your approval, my team and I will begin construction of a suitable facility. Thank you, Commander. I'll let you know when the facility is ready. Dr. Valen has asked to see you, Commander. No doubt she wishes to explain her plan personally.
Commander, I'm sure you've been briefed on my request. With your authorization, we can begin research on the Arc Thrower immediately.
Commander, we're picking up widespread radio chatter indicating UFO sightings within our current satellite coverage area. We should begin scanning for contacts as soon as possible. Looks like that satellite we launched paid off. We're picking up an unidentified fast mover. If we scramble an interceptor now, we may be able to take it down.
We have eyes on the bandit. Central, this is Voodoo 37. We have a confirmed kill on Bogey 001. I repeat, the UFO is down. I'll copy, over.
Solid copy, Voodoo 37. Nice work. Central out. All right, people. Retask Recon Satellite Bravo and get me a visual on that crash site.
She's coming into range now, sir.
On screen. Magnify. Still in one piece. Commander, I recommend we get a strike team to the crash site immediately.
Get ready to deploy. Our AO is within the continental United States. It looks like the aliens went down in a sparsely populated area. If there are civilians in the area, I hope they stay clear.
This is Big Sky. We're just north of the crash site. Strike One is in position to engage.
Loud and clear, Big Sky. We'll monitor those readings from here. Strike One is authorized to assault the alien craft.
Looks like the crash site is dead ahead. We should expect heavy resistance here. There's no telling how many hostiles were on board. Approach the craft with caution and attempt a breach if possible.
Go loud!
The alien craft is still intact. They've got some kind of energy field protecting parts of the ship. We'll have to look for an opening.
He's down.
about to start keeping score.
To withstand an impact like that, at such a velocity, the materials used in that vessel's hull must be at least an order of magnitude beyond any element we know of. Our readings can't be right. If they were, that's a being of almost pure energy. The readings coming from that creature are like nothing I've ever seen.
You can study it when it's dead, Doctor. Let's take that thing down.
Aye, affirmative.
Incredible. It seems to have vanished.
Welcome back, Commander. I wanted to speak to you about our current fleet of interceptors. It's crucial that we keep several of these aircraft on high alert. We'll need them to intercept any future alien contacts. And it's likely we'll suffer some losses in the process. I think it's also worth mentioning that even a full squadron of interceptors will do no good against our enemy if we don't know where they are. Additional satellite coverage will be required before we are able to detect alien craft elsewhere on the planet. Visit us in engineering should you wish to build additional satellites. Goodbye, Commander.
We've assembled everything we need to capture and house an alien for interrogation, Commander. The rest is up to our forces on the ground.
Commander, we've picked up multiple requests for assistance. Abductions in progress are marked on the hologlobe. Listen up. We're going to be dropping you deep in the Nigerian interior for the next operation. Alien activity continues to surge within several major cities. Our response is crucial to minimizing the spread of panic. Strike One, this is Central. You are free to engage all hostile contacts in the AO. Don't take any chances.
Alien object in sight.
Enemy contacts.
Confirmed.
99.
Excellent. Now we can begin preparing for the interrogation.
Chalk up another one.
Doctor?
Better than expected. Before the creature expired, I was able to extract some new information from it.
You're saying that thing spoke to you?
Not precisely, but when you have access to a creature's brain, Certain patterns can be discerned. He sends images and thoughts.
And what exactly was our late friend thinking about?
This particular image appeared in the creature's thought pattern several times throughout the procedure.
We've already met that thing, Doctor. This is hardly the kind of breakthrough we were...
And there was a neural link in the creature's mind between this image and this one.
That's the thing that pulled a disappearing act when we shot down our first UFO. And let me guess, you want to poke around in its head too.
It is the next piece of the puzzle. And this time, instead of shooting it, I suggest we try to capture it alive.
Get ready to deploy. Our AO is within the continental United States. Reports indicate the UFO set down in a sparsely populated area. We need to stay sharp and eliminate the invaders. Big Sky. Strike one, you are green to deploy. Approach with extreme caution. Current enemy status at the site is unknown.
Got it. Moving. This is a disturbing sight, to say the least. It's hard to differentiate where the organic material ends and the machine begins.
It's not going to win any beauty contest, that's for sure.
Neutralized. Dead and gone.
They're trying to pull back.
Aye, aye, Commander. Weapons free.
That alien is unusually human in its appearance. They could be using it as an infiltration unit of some kind. I'd recommend capturing it for further analysis. Instruct your men to exercise restraint when using explosives. While certainly effective at killing aliens, they also destroy the artifacts we're hoping to recover from the bodies. Just something to consider. We should make every attempt to capture one of those creatures using the arc thrower. There doesn't seem to be much left when we attack outright.
That looks like the primary power source for the alien craft. I could only hazard a guess as to the amount of power it would have to be generating to propel that ship. I'd watch your fire down there. That equipment could be highly unstable.
This new artifact as soon as you return.
Is that all that's left of the specimen we attempted to capture?
Yes. I believe we may have found the source of the strange readings we picked up when we first encountered it.
What is it, Doctor?
We're not exactly sure. It's organic in nature, yet highly magnetized, and it appears to resonate very faintly within a specific electromagnetic spectrum. It is currently unclear how or...
Perhaps that's because this is outside your field of expertise, Doctor. If what you're saying is true, this object is an antenna, one that's receiving a signal.
That signal, can we trace it?
No, at least not yet. We would first need to determine its encryption algorithm.
My team can handle that.
In that case, I will focus on constructing an interface between this object and our global communications array, which we'll need to trace the signal.
Then it looks like researching this crystal should be our top priority.
Breaking news at this hour. Reports from around the globe indicate a shift in the alien phenomena now affecting cities worldwide. We're now receiving word of outright attacks.
Looks like they've changed their tactics. But why? Why do this?
It's a message to the entire world that nothing can stop them.
We'll be heading into Japan for the next mission. We've gotten reports of alien activity taking place in a densely populated urban center. We should move to secure the area and minimize further civilian casualties.
Central, this is Big Sky. Confirm signal uplink. Strike team is in position near the terror site. Awaiting confirmation.
Solid copy, Big Sky. Strike One has been given the green light. Your highest priority is to protect those civilians.
You're clear. Go!
I'm all over.
Get to the ship and keep your head down.
Go on. Head to the ship.
X-ray down.
Kill confirmed.
Running. Why are you just standing around? Go!
This negates any hope we had of establishing a clear pattern of behavior among the alien species. This specimen is nothing like the others.
Seems like they've got one of everything.
Toasted.
everything by the numbers.
An eagle over these coordinates.
Recon satellite Delta 2 is just coming into line of sight now, sir. Coming on screen.
Nothing.
No, that's impossible. I know it's there.
Switch to thermal.
Hello.
Give me subsurface.
Gotcha.
Establish comms with all available ground.
Think of what we might find once we get inside that facility. Imagine what they might be doing down there.
I'm sure we'll find out soon enough.
Okay, we found it. Now how do we get inside?
I thought you'd never ask.
Thanks to Dr. Vollen's research and some clever developments done in engineering, this skeleton key should allow you to breach the alien compound. You've only got one chance to make this work, though, so let's make sure we do it right.
Reason to blow them to hell. Get moving.
So far, we don't have visual confirmation on the hostiles. I wouldn't get too comfortable, though. We're expecting heavy resistance. They're probably moving into position as we speak.
Location confirmed. Well, it looks like we found where they've been taking the abductees. But that still doesn't explain what the purpose of all this is.
Let's do this. Hostile spotted.
I didn't want to believe it, but it's clear the aliens have been experimenting on the abductees. What could they be hoping to accomplish through this?
Affirmative. Enemy in sight.
What could they possibly be storing in those tanks?
Rolling up.
it back! Now! Now, damn it! Now!
We got a KIN!
Confirmed. Kill confirmed.
As unprofessional as it sounds, the bite seems to have turned him into a zombie. Looks like a larger version of the sectoid, but something is different. What is that energy? That alien is clearly different from the others. It's wielding a power unlike anything we've previously encountered.
Got it. Moving. Got a lot of heat on me.
Seems to have taken control of that soldier somehow. All of the advances we've made so far, they would be useless against this type of power.
Wilco.
Feels like we're finally turning the tide. Now that we've captured their device, the aliens are running out of secrets.
It's imperative that we begin the research as soon as possible.
Now that we've captured this device, we should probably be expecting the aliens to pursue us more aggressively. I doubt losing it was part of their plan.
See you inside. Central out. Something wrong, Doctor?
Don't you think a victory celebration is a bit premature at this juncture?
We just neutralized their central command. We've got no other alerts on the entire system, and we took out their leader. In my book, that's a win, Doctor.
I'm glad to see that I'm not the only one who understands this war isn't over yet. The existence of this artifact, which we believe to be a communication device of some kind, begs the question. If the sectoid commander was the alien leader, then who or what was it communicating with? I believe this is indeed the same creature we encountered when we made first contact with the aliens. As we have observed, it is somehow capable of using its mind as a weapon. If we were to study this specimen's brain tissue, perhaps we might be able to adapt this ability for our own purposes.
Commander, the genetics lab is now prepped and fully staffed. We can begin genetic modification of our soldiers on your order. This facility will be the nerve center of our genetic modification program. Our soldiers will receive entirely new capabilities, making them more effective on the battlefield than ever before. As we improve our understanding of alien genetics, the range of available modifications will expand.
We are on the threshold of a new kind of warfare. Our soldiers were already humanity's best warriors. Now, as we learn from our fallen enemies, we can make their strengths our own.
The soldiers who volunteer for mech trooper augmentation sacrifice much, but they do not leave themselves entirely behind. A mech trooper will be able to apply some of the training and knowledge from his or her previous combat specialty to the cybersuit's operation. With this facility, we'll be able to build mechanized exoskeletal cybersuits, or mechs, and implant our soldiers with the cybernetic interfaces they'll need to deploy these mechs onto the battlefield. The cybernetic interfaces are holding stable, but they're of no use without a cybersuit to interface with. I suggest we manufacture one immediately. When our new mech trooper equips that suit, I think you'll be pleasantly surprised with its capabilities.
Internal systems are shutting down all over HQ.
This is Central. Security status red. Repeat.
Sensors have been tripped. We have a breach.
Hostile forces have infiltrated XCOM headquarters and are moving in with reinforcements. We have to protect the base at all costs. If we don't hold the line here, any hope we had of stopping this invasion will be lost. Delta Section, report. Delta Section, report. Finally, Delta Section. It looks like your emergency generators are back online, and Delta, whatever this attack is, you're right in the crosshairs. We've got perimeter alerts triggering from all sides. It looks like you've got flyers coming through the cavern near the rear guard station. Plus, you've got a whole wall of heat signatures coming down through the vents in the ceiling above you. Whoever breached our internal security locked down the door system, separating you from the rest of the base. Once we get the doors open again, we can start sending reinforcements through, but that might take some time. Right now, it looks like the closest alarms being triggered are in the vents above you. Keep an eye out for any indications of movement. Delta Section, you have to hold the line. The future of XCOM is counting on you.
It appears the aliens have outfitted the septoid creature we previously encountered with some form of mechanized body armor. This was likely an effort to improve their combat power. We should exercise caution.
You've got fresh reinforcements standing by, Commander. The bad news is we drained the auxiliary power banks while holding the doors open. It's going to take some time to reroute power for another attempt.
X-ray neutralized. X-ray down.
Incoming fire!
Airborne hostiles moving on the rear guard station, Commander. I'm not sure the alien ground forces can reach that area. They may be limited to aerial units.
Get a read on that thing. Its movements are so inconsistent.
got the auxiliary power banks charged, and I should be able to get one of the interior blast doors open. I'll send as many reinforcements through as I can before the charge dissipates and the door locks down again.
We've seen so far, it was only natural to assume the aliens would have something specialized towards frontline combat. This hulking creature appears to be that unit.
I don't envy anyone who is to go up against that thing.
We've got more reinforcements awaiting orders, Commander. As soon as the power banks spool up again, I'll send another group through.
Suppressing fire. Firepower over here.
Looks like this is the last of them, Commander. We're not picking up any additional contacts. If we can take them out, HQ will be secure. At the heart of our operation, and we showed them what happens. Now I think it's time we take the fight back to them. Hang in there, soldier.
Having to fight our own people.
Will he be okay, Doctor?
Yes, I believe he'll recover. And more importantly, he seems to be free from outside control.
Is there any indication of how this happened, Doctor?
I finished our initial scans. And so far, I found no physical abnormalities.
We already know the aliens are capable of some kind of mind control, Doctor.
Yes, but that doesn't explain the lack of a nearby controlling alien. The sheer number of victims.
If the aliens were capable of launching an attack of this scale previously, I believe they would have. Perhaps this was a one-time opportunity.
That might be true. But we still need to find out how this was possible.
Commander,
Our intelligence sources indicate that a previously unknown organization is attempting to undermine XCOM field operations. We believe this group harbors some misguided sympathies for the invaders and is intent on acquiring alien technology and artifacts critical to your efforts. Early reports indicate this organization calls itself Exalt. We trust you will isolate the source of this new threat and eliminate it.
Commander, the Council has provided some additional resources to help us deal with these traitors. We can begin scanning for additional Exalt cell locations and launch covert operations to disrupt their activity via the Situation Room.
The latest contact turned out to be a dud. Probably just another drunk pilot who fell asleep on a long haul.
Covert operative deployed to disrupt Exalt cell in South Africa.
We're aiming to eliminate an Exalt cell currently operating out of South Africa. We'll need to move in and assist our operative in acquiring the necessary data. Exalt forces spooked one of our field operatives who was attempting to recover new intelligence by hacking an Exalt comm relay. Strike One is going in to ensure the operative is covered while decrypting the data from the remaining relays. We have to keep that operative alive if we're going to recover the remaining intel. New objective received.
Orders confirmed. Moving out. Look sharp.
We finally have a visual confirmation of Exalt's operatives in the field. And from the looks of them, Exalt is working quickly to integrate alien genetic material into their troops. Until we know the extent of their capabilities, I would advise extreme caution.
Yes, Commander.
Yes, sir. Enemy spotted. They're trying to flank us. Fire in the hole.
Is in position near a comm relay. We just need to activate it to retrieve the missing data. Excellent. You've decrypted a piece of the data, and it looks like Exalt communications were temporarily disrupted by the hack. Now we just need to find the remaining relays. The last of the data. Now we just need to get our operative to the evac point. We have a new objective.
Moving to designated coordinates.
Commander, The operative has safely reached the extraction point with the recovered data. We can either stick around and eliminate any remaining hostiles, or move to the evac point and return to HQ. Objectives updated.
Headed there now. Solid copy.
Excellent work, Commander. Our operative and some valuable new intel are safe and sound.
The intel we recovered was enough to take down the rest of Exalt's cell. Unfortunately, it looks like this was just a small part of their wider-reaching clandestine operation. We did manage to find some clues as to the location of Exalt's headquarters, though. If we can track down more of their cells and collect additional intel, we'll be able to narrow down the possibilities and take out Exalt once and for all.
France is sending an urgent mission request. It looks like the transport came under attack while attempting to cross that dam. Judging from the damage, the aliens must have strafed the entire area trying to slow the truck down. If they want this thing that badly, there's no telling what else they might send in to try and retrieve it. That dam is in bad shape, though. We'll need to move quickly if we're going to secure the truck before they do.
Double time.
The dam has already taken heavy damage, but it looks like we can delay the collapse if we open the bypass valves positioned along the way to the transport.
Affirmative. Moving out.
Commander, we've got hostile aircraft moving in the vicinity of Strike One's position. Looks like the aliens are bringing in reinforcements to go after the truck. Still need to secure the truck before it's too late.
Heading to that location.
That was close.
I'm all right.
Bypass valve is open, but we're not done yet. Keep moving, Strike One.
I'm rolling.
Commander, we've got hostile aircraft moving in the vicinity of Strike One's position. It looks like the aliens are bringing in reinforcements to go after the truck.
Thank you. Please. You don't understand. I have to get to the others. You can't. You don't get it. Do you know how many of us they killed? You can kill them? But ow! Please, you have to help me find the others.
Great work out there, Commander. It looks like the weapon everyone was after may be even more valuable than we thought. This captive we recovered from the aliens, Annette, was apparently passed off to them by the Exalt organization. So far, she's been less than forthcoming about how she wound up in their control, or what makes her so valuable that they'd pursue her to this extent. Whatever the case, we need to keep a close eye on her.
Although my initial observations of the abductee Annette revealed little to explain the alien's ongoing interest in her, after conducting structural imaging scans of her brain, there was some evidence of focused trauma. At this point, it is clear she harbors a latent psionic ability, something different than we've encountered in the field. My hope is that she'll slowly piece together what's happened.
Annette is confident that within the last few months of her captivity, Exalt forces launched a direct assault on the aliens in order to recapture her for themselves. If what she's saying is true, Exalt is even more brazen and dangerous than we initially suspected.
I am certain now that Annette was somehow involved in the attack on XCOM headquarters. Her limited memories of the event include details that no one outside of our organization could possibly know. But the question remains, what is it about her that makes her so valuable to the aliens?
France is sending an urgent mission request. Commander, Strike One needs to approach that ship with caution. According to Annette, the remaining captives are being held in stasis, but the aliens can shut down life support functions at any moment. The system is controlled by a command console. If we can take it out, it'll give us a chance to bring those people home safe. Objective updated. Damn it. The aliens are onto you, Strike One. That sound is coming from the console. Get moving and find it before the aliens execute those captives.
Yes, sir. Three down.
like the abductees are still alive. But we're not out of the woods yet. We still have to get them out of there. From Annette's description, that has to be the command console. If we're going to save the captives, we'll need to either move in and disable the system or destroy it with explosives. Additional alien contacts approaching Strike One's position, Commander.
Headed there now. It's raining death over here!
Excellent work out there, Commander. We're reading zeros across the board on that device. Looks like you managed to stop the termination sequence. New objective received. All we need to do now is secure the area and eliminate any remaining hostiles.
Aliens over there.
On this one, and we still managed to pull through. The three remaining captives have been secured, and if we're lucky, we may just have found some new recruits for XCOM.
We may have finally found the purpose behind Annette's captivity, and the results are disturbing, to say the least. It appears that Annette and the other unique captives are capable of amplifying the psionic abilities of others, allowing the aliens to exert mental control over a number of victims simultaneously. Unfortunately, in using Annette to attack XCOM, the resulting stress caused significant trauma to her neural tissue. She will never have this specific ability again, although she may still retain psionic aptitude. We can now submit our soldiers for testing within the Psylab. Once we have a complete report, I'll notify you with the results. Our current research implies a strong link between a candidate's willpower and their psionic potential. We're hoping that one or more of our existing soldiers will meet the necessary requirements.
Ever since mankind first looked up at the stars, we have wondered what lies beyond. So very few have dared to look inward. The depths of the human mind hold more secrets than we can possibly imagine. How ironic that the means to defeat our enemy comes not through weapons or machines of war, but from within. And if we have succeeded, we will have gained a glimpse of what we are to become. We will have created something extraordinary.
that we are in control of the hyperwave beacon, the real question is, what is it going to tell us? Perhaps we should try scanning for UFO activity in the meantime.
Wait, what did you do? Shut it down.
Do not touch anything.
This could be what we've been waiting for.
Inbound from the hyperwave uplink.
This gamble seems to have paid off, but we've endangered the lives of everyone involved to satisfy the doctor's curiosity.
The risk was worth the reward. If we hadn't pushed on, there's no way we would have gotten this information.
Eyes on the bandit. Putting down in Mexico for this mission. It looks like we got lucky. The alien crash site is in a remote area, away from any major city centers. We should get down there and secure the site ASAP. They've been protecting this ship with their most advanced technology. So it's safe to assume whatever they've gotten there is crucial to their invasion effort. We should expect heavy resistance. They're not going to make this easy on us.
Moving to target location. Enemy target in range.
My flank!
Watch the flanks!
They got me flanked!
On my way!
Positive enemy contacts.
The aliens seem to be fielding mechanized units more frequently, and with a much greater range of firepower. How are we going to combat something of that size?
We could probably spend years analyzing the inner workings of that thing.
Just as before, we're seeing a gradual progression in the development of the alien subjects. That heavy armor looks to be near impenetrable.
As if the first mutons weren't bad enough. Now they're covering them in armor plating.
Anything else we've previously identified. Based on its physical appearance, I would assume this alien doesn't rely on brute strength. I recommend the troops exercise extreme caution, Commander.
I think I liked it better when the weapons were obvious. Position confirmed.
Commander, that device, it seems to be of great importance to them. Retrieving it for further study should be our highest priority.
Heading there now. X-ray neutralized. Incoming
weapons fire.
on the move. Approaching hostile target.
I'm on it, Commander.
From a cloaked ship and guarded by the most powerful being we've ever encountered. What do you think it is?
An object of immense power. Think of all we could do if we unlocked its secrets.
A dangerous sentiment, Doctor.
Sir, I'm picking something up.
Another cloaked ship?
No, sir. It's big.
Tell me that was a coincidence.
Wish I could, sir. That seismic event originated directly beneath our new contact.
Nothing we have would even make a dent in that thing. If you two have any more bright ideas, now's the time.
Exalt base location identified.
That's it, Commander. Based on the compiled intelligence reports, we've confirmed the location of Exalt's primary base. We can launch an assault against the facility on your order. We're en route to Exalt's headquarters. On the top floor of an office complex downtown. We have no intel on the number of operatives stationed in that facility, but we should expect heavy resistance. Our objective for this operation is simple. Eliminate any Exalt forces within the building and wipe out this threat once and for all. Good luck, Strike One.
Affirmative. Moving out. Here they come.
Looks like Exalt prefers form over function. Not what I'd call a winning strategy.
Attention. Access detected. Security breach in progress. All personnel report to security stations.
Copy. Moving on target. Taking fire. Positive enemy contacts. Managed to replicate our hollow globe. Into that location. Hostiles pacify.
Heading out. Kill confirmed. Haul an ass.
They seem to have acquired a vast array of technology on par with our own.
Keeping score. Moving.
The side. Our local affiliates at WFXS indicate that a minor electrical fire was reported near the upper floors of a large office building downtown. Sources indicate that first responders were on the scene within minutes. So far, there have been no reported injuries. In light of the recent events taking place around the globe, it's certainly reassuring to know that our emergency services personnel are still putting their lives at risk to deal with these situations as they arise.
Commander, with Exalt's headquarters destroyed and the remaining forces in hiding, we shouldn't have any further need for our covert operations section. I think it's time we refocused our efforts on the aliens themselves.
With each of our major victories, we have encountered incrementally more powerful aliens. After the first alien craft was shot down, they began a campaign of terror. The alien forces were led by a sectoid commander, a powerful psionic creature. Upon capturing the hyperwave beacon, we detected a cloaked ship carrying a being of incredible psionic power. Having captured the device it sacrificed itself to protect, an immense alien ship has now appeared within our atmosphere. We can only assume that a being of even greater psionic power is on board this vessel. We have already pushed human evolution so far, and I fear where the next step will take us. But our enemy leaves us with no other choice. A new type of weapon is required.
At long last, you have succeeded where we have failed. You hear our voice, new one. Now listen well. Long have we watched and waited. So many promising subjects. So many failed efforts. And now, after untold trials, the new emerges to face the rigors of our collective, an enduring physical form paired with an equally adept mental capacity, the rarest of traits finally within our grasp.
When do I get to shoot an alien? I suppose I do owe you that. I got one!
The new one faces the earliest effort of the ethereal ones. The first failure. Possessed of certain brilliance, they were marred by their cowardice and frailty, which made them cruel and ultimately useless.
Rolling.
I'll go. Don't worry, your friends will join you soon. To me, you have no choice.
Serving only to fight and die as
Rockets away.
He's down. Aye, aye, Commander.
Thank you.
on it, Commander. No longer a threat.
Move. X-rays spotted. Commander. Thank you. my head!
Heading to that location. Ready to go.
Thank you.
light of the recent extraterrestrial incursion, this Council of Nations has convened to approve the activation of the XCOM project. You have been chosen to lead this initiative, to oversee our first and last line of defense. Your efforts will have considerable influence on this planet's future. We urge you to keep that in mind as you proceed. Good luck, Commander.
That was the last transmission, sir.
Patch me through to Voodoo 3-1.
You are being deployed to Germany. At 1900 hours Zulu, several unidentified objects fell to Earth. After ruling out the possibility of a downed satellite, we now believe these objects to be extraterrestrial in nature. Shortly after impact, German officials received reports of mass hysteria and freak weather around one of the impact zones. Then things went dark. At 2100 hours, a chopper carrying a German military recon team went down in the area after they reported being fired upon. As you know, Germany is a member of the Council, and they have requested our assistance. Our mission is to assess the situation on the ground, ascertain the current status of the German recon team, and investigate the extraterrestrial objects. Central out.
Central, this is Big Sky. Looks like we found the crash site.
Roger, Voodoo 3-1. Any sign of activity?
Negative. Nothing's moving down there.
Okay. Set her down nearby.
Central, you getting all this?
Copy that, Delta Squad. First things first, let's get you out of the open and into cover. Whatever did this could still be out there.
Central, I have movement. 30 meters north of my position. Police vehicle.
Roger. Proceed to the next vehicle for a better vantage point. Delta 4, go check it out. It's a long way from your position, and there's no available cover between here and there, so you better double time it.
Holy hell.
What do you see, Delta 4? Report.
Looks like one of the recon teams, sir. It looks like something.
Is that your man, Delta 4?
Negative, sir. That's someone else.
Dr. Vollen, what's he saying?
He is saying, help me. That radio transmission is coming from somewhere north of the squad's current position. Based on its strength, probably from inside a structure.
Central, I think I just found another one of the recon team. Or what's left of him. But this doesn't make sense. Looks like he's been dead for a week.
Even more perplexing is the cause of death. It appears that he was eviscerated when something burst out of him from the inside.
Sir, I have visual on the object. Permission to approach.
It's the only cover between you and that building. Permission granted.
Talk to me, soldier. What is it?
I got no idea what this thing is, but I can confirm that it's no satellite.
Roger. All right, Delta Squad. You're almost to the building. Keep moving.
Central, we have eyes on the target. He's armed.
Copy, Delta 3. Okay, everyone. Get into position nearby, but do not approach. Doctor, see if you can communicate with him. Tell him to drop his weapon.
I will try. Hello. Können Sie mich hören? Wir sind hier, um Ihnen zu helfen. Bitte lassen Sie Ihre Waffen fallen. He appears to be in shock.
Keep your eyes open, people. I don't like the looks of this. Delta 3, move in and disarm him. Carefully.
One is down.
Central, we're taking fire from multiple X-rays.
This guy's got me pinned down, taking heavy fire.
Damn it. Delta 2, you're flank 2. Find some better cover. All right, Delta 2. Weapons free. Get ready to fire. Nice shot. Delta 4, you're freed up to move. Get out of there and get into cover. Now toss your grenade at the enemy in front of you. Now get ready for their counterattack. Look out, Delta 4. There's another one coming in behind you. Damn it. It's just you now, Delta 2. Let's tip the odds in our...
Just sent us some new schematics. With your approval, we will begin fabrication. Fabrication of the scope device is complete. It has been delivered to the armory.
We've made a number of interesting discoveries based on the autopsy results of the alien specimen you brought back. The research team is now referring to this particular variation as a sectoid, based on the unusual structure of its internal organs, which we believe to be the product of genetic manipulation. As we've seen in the field, this species also seems to harbor some sort of telepathic ability.
Commander, the Council has requested a word.
Commander, our sources have identified a number of reports regarding alien involvement in the transportation and dispersal of an unknown substance near civilian population centers. It is imperative that you investigate this activity and determine the purpose of the alien material. We will transmit further details momentarily.
Sounds like we better get to it.
That object is different from the others. It does not appear to be the same type of pod we've seen used by the aliens during their abduction operations. We may gain new insights if we recover it.
Be advised, Commander. Intel confirms enemy activity in this area.
Solid copy.
This appears to be a containment device of some kind. We can only assume it has an internal self-destruct mechanism like the other alien equipment. Although it must have already been disabled somehow.
There may be additional canisters like this one in the area. The more we can recover, the more we'll learn about what's inside them.
Any others you find may still have operational self-destruct modules. Be careful. The energy signature coming from that device implies the self-destruct mechanism is still intact and priming for detonation. You need to move quickly to recover it before it's too late.
Excellent work, Commander. That should provide us with an ample supply of this substance for analysis.
So, what is it, Doctor?
It's remarkable. The crystalline structure housed within the canister is actually a suspension containing billions of cybernetic nanomachines, each made up of both organic and mechanical components.
My team's analysis indicates these microscopic robots are capable of assembling mechanical structures with unprecedented efficiency. With further study and some specialized facilities, we may be able to engineer a sort of cyber suit that interfaces with the human body.
My team is more interested in the possibility of physically altering the tissue itself, incorporating aspects of the alien's own genetic adaptations by using the nanites to fuse the foreign material.
The Commander will have to decide where the greatest advantage lies. Is there anything you agree on?
Given the apparent purpose of the nanites, they allow combining organic materials with one another, or with machines. We have at least agreed to call them
meld.
Around for a position where you can flank the enemy. That's it. You have a clear shot from that position. Fire.
Central, I think that's it. It's over.
Roger that, Delta. Secure the bodies and head back to the Skyranger for immediate extraction. Whatever they are, they nearly took out a squad of our best soldiers. If you'll excuse me, doctors, the commander is waiting in mission control.
Their technology is far beyond ours.
Then I'd say our work is cut out for us, Doctor.
Welcome to XCOM HQ, Commander. I'm Central Officer Bradford. My role in this project is twofold: providing tactical support for our field operations, and keeping you briefed on the current situation. My efforts should allow you to focus on the bigger issues at hand. Speaking of which, we have a soldier waiting for a promotion in the barracks. I'll let you get to it.
Only one recruit from Delta Squad made it back alive from our last mission, Commander. And I'd say a promotion is in order. As you know, Commander, every soldier is different. This particular soldier has shown an aptitude for heavy weapons. As he gains additional combat experience, we should continue his training along these lines. This soldier will now carry a rocket launcher in addition to his standard weapon. The aliens won't know what hit him. Oh, Dr. Vollen asked to see you in the research labs, Commander. It sounded important.
Hello, Commander. My name is Dr. Vollen. I oversee the research labs. This is where all of XCOM's research and development takes place. We have already begun analyzing the artifacts recovered from our first encounter with the aliens. Based on our preliminary findings, we believe we can use them to develop some new equipment for our soldiers. With your approval, we will begin research immediately. Thank you, Commander. This research will take some time. We will notify you once it is complete.
Commander to Mission Control. Commander to
It sounds
control.
Like you are needed elsewhere. Farewell, Commander. If you recover any additional artifacts during your field operations, I would be quite eager to study them.
The enemy is testing our capabilities, Commander. We've gotten reports of simultaneous attacks in two different countries. We can only respond to one. The country we help will donate more resources to our cause. But the panic level of the country we choose not to help will rise. It's not an easy decision, Commander, but it's one you'll have to make.
Understood. The troops are waiting for you in the hangar.
Commander, before deploying our squad, you can choose which soldiers to send out there. I've taken the liberty of calling up our veteran. His combat experience makes him invaluable on the battlefield.
The enemy and get into cover. Hold your fire until I give the word.
No longer a threat. Enemy spotted.
Our veteran's rocket launcher should make easy work of the structure the aliens are using for cover. And if we're lucky, it'll take out the aliens along with it. That is, if it hits. Commander will be assuming command now as you sweep the rest of the area. As always, I'll be offering tactical advice as needed. And remember, your armor can only withstand a couple of shots from their weapons. So keep your eyes open and your heads down. Good luck.
He's down.
Good work out there, Strike One.
If I may, Commander, the labs are on high alert. Teams are standing by for your orders. We can begin researching the newly recovered artifacts immediately.
Commander, we have an incoming transmission from the Council.
Hello, Commander. We wish to congratulate you on your most recent victory. We realize you were faced with a difficult decision in responding to the various requests for assistance. Regardless, you performed admirably. As agreed upon, the reward for your actions has been granted. Farewell, Commander. We hope that you are met with continued success.
The Council knows you made the right decision, Commander. With the resources we have available, there's only so much we can do. However, our chief engineer did come up with something to help you keep an eye on things.
The Situation Room provides constant monitoring of every member nation in the Council. If we allow panic levels to get out of control in any given nation, they're going to withdraw from the Council. And they'll take their funding and additional support with them. The Council's overall confidence in the XCOM project is shown on the primary meter above the main screen, which engineering has nicknamed the Doom Tracker.
Hello, Commander. The current research task is progressing as expected. However, it will still be some time before the schematics are ready for engineering. I'm sure you have other pressing matters to attend to in the meantime.
Commander, Dr. Vallen reports that research is progressing in the labs, but it will still be some time before the project is complete. While we're waiting, our local satellite network has just come online, and we can now begin scanning for new activity. The process could take several days.
Commander, with this research complete, my staff and I currently have nothing to study. I would like to ask your permission to autopsy the alien cadavers retrieved from your last two field operations. I'm sure you would agree that if we're going to defeat the aliens, we must understand their physiology. Thank you, Commander. I will let you know when this research has been completed.
Engineering online.
It appears Dr. Shen's staff have finally figured out how to turn their machines on.
Ah, Commander. I was wondering when you'd be stopping by. Welcome to engineering. Anything they can dream up in the research labs, we can build it here. Speaking of which, Dr. Vallen has...